Hello everyone, so in today's video, we are going to go over this paper titled A Review of Human Evaluation for Style Transfer. This paper is by Eleftheria Briaco, Shweta Agarwal, K. Zhang, Joel Tetrol, and Marine Karpor. They are from the University of Maryland and Data Miner Incorporated. So, I'm really sorry if I mispronounce any of those names, but I found this title really interesting. This is a recent paper and I've been covering a lot of style transfer papers, so, and a lot of them have human evaluations, so I thought this would be an interesting read, so I'll be reading it along with you guys. So the abstract: this paper reviews and summarizes human evaluation practices described in 97 style transfer papers with respect to three main evaluation aspects: style transfer, meaning preservation, and fluency. In principle, evaluations by human raters should be the most reliable. However, in style transfer papers, we find the protocols for human evaluation are often underspecified and not standardized, which hampers the reproducibility of research in this field and progress towards better human and automatic evaluation methods. So I guess this is simply because these are very subjective things. So one team might think that a good measure of style is something, while another might think something else. So there should be a standard way to for the human annotators to judge what score they should give. So the introduction: style transfer (ST) in NLP refers to a broad spectrum of text generation tasks that aim to rewrite a sentence to change a specific attribute of language used in context while preserving others. With the success of deep sequence-to-sequence models and the relative ease of collecting data covering various stylistic attributes, neural style transfer is a popular generation task with more than 100 papers published in this area over the last 10 years. Despite the growing interest that ST receives from the NLP community, progress is hampered by the lack of standardized evaluation practices. One practical aspect that contributes to this problem is the conceptualization and formalization of styles in natural language. According to a survey of neural style transfer by Jin et al. In the context of NLP, ST is used to refer to tasks where styles follow a linguistically motivated dimension of language variation, such as formality, and also to tasks where the distinction between style and content is implicit, so something like positive and negative. So across these tasks, ST quality is usually evaluated across three dimensions: style transfer, so has the desired attribute been changed as intended, meaning preservation, are the other attributes preserved, and fluency, is the output well formed. Given the large spectrum of stylistic attributes studied and the lack of naturally occurring references for the associated style transfer tasks, prior work emphasizes the limitation of automatic evaluation. As a result, progress in this growing field relies heavily on human evaluations to quantify progress among the three evaluation aspects. So, inspired by the recent critiques of human evaluations of natural language generation systems, we conduct a structured review of human evaluation for neural style transfer, as their evaluation is primarily based on human judgment. Concretely, out of the 97 papers we received, 69 of them resort to human evaluation, where it is treated either as a substitute for automatic metrics or as a more reliable evaluation. So you can see a number of papers employing human evaluation for style transfer, meaning preservation, fluency, all of them, at least one of them or another aspect. So you can see 52 of them used human evaluation for style transfer, 54 for meaning preservation, 51 for fluency, 64 for all of them, 37 for at least one of them, and 21 for others. So I guess this doesn't make much sense in some sense, because if it's at least one of them, then all of them should also come under this, right? So I guess they've not considered removed cases, so maybe that's why. And others is 21. Alright. So the paper summarizes the findings of the review and raises the following concerns on current human evaluation practices. So, under specification, We find that many attributes of human annotation detail are underspecified, so annotator detail, annotation framework, which hampers reproducibility and replicability, availability and reliability. The vast majority of papers do not release the human ratings and do not give details that can help assess their quality, which hurts research on evaluation. Lack of standardization. The annotation protocols are inconsistent across papers, which hampers comparison across system. So there is possible bias in annotation frameworks. The paper is organized as follows. In section 2, we describe our procedure for analyzing the 97 papers and summarizing their evaluation. In section 3, we present and analyze our finding. Finally, in section 4, we conclude with a discussion of where the field of style transfer fares with respect to human evaluation today and outline improvements for future works in this area. So, paper selection, we select papers for the study from the list compiled by Jin et al. 2021, who conduct a comprehensive review of style transfer that covers the task formulation, evaluation metrics, opinion papers, and deep learning based textual style transfer methods. The paper list contains more than 100 papers and is publicly available. So I think I am already, I've started this repository. You can definitely check this repository out. It has a lot of style transfer papers. We reviewed all papers in this list to determine whether they conduct either human or automatic evaluation on system output for style transfer and therefore should be included in a structured review. We did not review papers for text simplification as it has been studied separately in these works, and metrics for automatic evaluation have been widely adopted. Our final list consists of 97 papers. 86 of them are from top tier NLP and AI venues, so ACL, ESEL, EMNLP, NAACL, TSEL, IEEE, AAAI, NeurIPS, ICML and ICLR, and the remaining 11 are preprints which have not been peer reviewed. So review structure, we review each paper based on a predefined set of criteria in table 2. The rationale behind their choice is to collect information on the evaluation aspects that are underspecified in NLP in general, as well as those to the style transfer task. So for this work, we call the former global criteria. The latter is called dimension specific criteria and is meant to illustrate issues with how each dimension like style transfer, meaning preservation and fluency is evaluated. So, alright, so you have the task, the presence of human annotator, detail, annotator, compensation, quality control, annotation availability and so on. Then you have dimension specific, so quality criteria name, the direct response, elicitation, relative judgment type, direct rating scale, presence of lineage reference, lineage source and so on. So this makes sense. So global criteria can be split into three categories, the ST stylistic attribute, four details about the annotators and their compensation, four general design choices of the human evaluation that are not tied to a specific evaluation dimension. For a dimension specific criteria, we repurpose the following operationalization attributes introduced by Hofcraft et al. Form of response, elicitation, so direct versus relative. Details on type of collected responses, size, scale of rating instrument, the statistics computed on response values. Finally, we also collect information on the quality criterion for each dimension. So that is the wording used in the paper to refer to the specific evaluation dimension. Alright. So the process. The review was conducted by the authors of this survey. We first went through each of the 97 papers and highlighted the sections which included mentions of human evaluation. Next, we developed our criteria by creating a draft based on the prior work and issues we had faced in the first step. We then discussed and refined the criteria after testing it on a subset of the papers. Once the criteria were finalized, we split the papers evenly between all the authors. Annotations were spot-checked to resolve uncertainties or concerns that were found in reviewing dimension-specific criteria. Example, scale of rating instrument is not explicitly defined but inferred from the results. And the global criteria, so number of systems not specified but inferred from tables. We released the spreadsheet used to conduct the review along with the reviewed PDFs that come with the highlights on the human evaluation section of each paper. Okay, so this is a good keeping. I'll keep a fork because this might come in handy later. So the findings. Based on our review, we first discussed trends on stylistic attributes. followed by global criteria of human evaluation and then turn to domain specific criteria. So table 3 presents statistics on the different style attributes contained in style transfer papers in 2011. First, we observe a significant increase in the number of papers starting in 2018. In 2017, there were 8. In the following year, there were 28. We believe this can be attributed to the creation of standardized tasks and evaluation datasets for various style transfer tasks. One example is the Yelp dataset, which consists of positive and negative review and is used for unsupervised sentiment transfer et al. Another example is the GYAFC parallel corpus. This is the one by Grammarly, which consists of informal formal pairs that are generated using crowdsourced human rewrites. Second, we notice the new stylistic attributes are studied through time, 21 over the last 10 years, with sentiment and formality transfer being the most frequently studied. So number of style transfer papers per stylistic attribute across years. So in the year 2011, we only had one on formality. In 2012, we only had one on author imitation. In 2016, we had two on gender and persona. In 2017, we had one on attractiveness, two on author imitation, four on sentiment, and one on prose. And then you can see it just boomed. So in total, there are about 125 papers. So in 2020, the full year, there were 48. And I guess even in 2021, there might be a lot more papers which were still in preprint or were not publicly released yet. Alright, so now the global criteria annotators. So table 4 summarizes statistics about how many papers describe the background of their human judges. The majority of works, 38%, rely on crowd workers mostly recruited using the Amazon Mechanical Turk crowdsourcing platform. Interestingly, for a substantial number of evaluations, it is unclear who the annotators are and what their background is. In addition, we find the information about how much participants were compensated is missing from all but 2 papers. Finally, many papers collected 3 independent annotations, although this information is not specified in a significant percentage of evaluations. In short, the ability to replicate a human evaluation from the bulk of current research is extremely challenging and in many cases impossible, as so much is underspecified. So you can see there was a qualification when they were crowdsourcing. They used qualification tests, number of approved hits, and or directly hire Amazon Mechanical Turk workers. Then they, without crowdsourcing, they had these people. So from research groups, volunteers, and so on. And then unclear, these terms were used: human judges, individuals, and so on. So annotation reliability. Only 31% of evaluation methods that rely on crowdsourcing employ quality control. The most common quality control strategies are to require workers to pass a qualification test, to hire the top ranked workers based on a pre-computed score that reflect the number of their past approved tasks, to use location restrictions, or to perform manual checks on the collected annotations. Furthermore, only 20% of the papers reported inter-annotator agreement statistics, and only 4 released the actual annotations to facilitate their reproducibility and further analysis of their results. Without this information, it is difficult to replicate the evaluation and compare different evaluation approaches. So this makes sense, and I guess I'm just reading through it, but this is because there's not much to explain here. It all makes perfect sense just by reading. Data selection. Human evaluation is typically performed on a sample of the test set used for automatic evaluation. Most work, 62%, sample instances randomly from the set, with a few exceptions that employ stratified sampling according to the number of stylistic categories considered. So, for example, random sampling from positive and negative classes for a binary definition of style. For 25% of style transfer papers, information on the sampling method is not available. Furthermore, the sample size of instances evaluated per system varies from 50 to 1000, with most of them concentrated around 100. So, dimension specific criteria. Quality criteria names. So, table 5 summarizes the test used to refer to the 3 main dimensions of style transfer: meaning preservation, and fluency. As Hofcraft et al. 2020 found, in the context of natural language generation evaluation, we see that the name of these dimensions are not standardized for the 3 ST evaluation dimensions. Each dimension has at least 6 different ways that past literature has referred to them. We should note that even with the same name, the nature of the evaluation is not necessarily the same. For instance, what constitutes content preservation differs in formality transfer and in sentiment transfer, since the latter arguably changes the semantics of the original text, while fluency is the aspect of evaluation that might be most generalizable across style transfer tasks, since fluency, of course, is, you know, when something is fluent and when it is not fluent. It is referred to in inconsistent ways across papers, which could lead to different interpretation by author annotators. For instance, the same text could be rated as natural but not grammatical. Overall, the variability in terminology makes it harder to understand exactly what is being evaluated and to compare evaluation methods across papers. This makes sense as well. So table 6 presents statistics on rating type, direct versus relative per dimension over time. Direct rating refers to evaluation where each system output is assessed in isolation. Relative rating refers to evaluation where two or more system outputs are compared. Rating types were inconsistently used before 2020, with recent convergences towards direct assessment. Among papers that report rating type, direct assessment is the most frequent approach for all evaluation aspects over the years 2018 to 2021. Table 7, 8, and 9 summarize the range of responses elicited for direct and relative ratings. They cover diverse definitions of scales within each rating type. Across evaluation aspects, the dominant evaluation framework is direct rating on a 5-point scale. However, while the configuration is what the field tends to focus on, there is clearly a wide range of choices that the field also considers, which once again make comparing human evaluation head-to-head very difficult. So these are pretty subjective and author dependent. So let's have a look at the tables. So this is the one for the quality criterion. So style is referred by all these names, meaning by all these names, fluency by all these names. Then you also have, like, these are the quality criteria names to enforce fluency and so on. So these are the number of papers which use which rating type for which attribute. Then we have style results. So number, which paper use which style category. The most popular is highlighted. So the most popular was 1 to 5. And even this, it was 1 to 5. Even here it is 1 to 5 for meaning preservation and fluency. All right. So figure 2 shows how the human evaluation setup used in each reviewed paper is based on cited prior work for each dimension over time. Only 19% of papers repurpose or reuse some prior work. Most of these papers target ST for formality or sentiment. Even when evaluating fluency or meaning preservation, more than 50% of the papers do not refer to any prior work. This is striking because it suggests that there is currently not a strong effort to replicate prior human evaluations. For papers that mention lineage, the most common setup for the evaluation meaning preservation and fluency is Lee et al. 43% of papers that work on sentiment transfer also refer to Lee et al. Some papers follow Aguirre et al. For measuring textual similarity, Hillman et al. For grammaticality, and Palvik and Tretol 2016 for formality. So you can see lineage statistics, the number of papers for each style transfer evaluation aspect over the years. So you can see this just shows like the orange bar show that they did not have any lineage, and the blue bar shows they had lineage. So you can see a lot of papers are using their own methods instead of using some previous works. So discussion and recommendation. Our structured review shows that human evaluation protocols for style transfer are mostly underspecified and lack standardization, which fundamentally hinders progress. The following attributes are commonly underspecified. So details on procedures followed for recruiting annotators, annotator compensation, inter-annotator agreement, number of annotation, number of systems evaluated, number of instances annotated, selection method of annotated instance, detailed description of evaluation framework, and so on. So these examples for I didn't mean to do that. So furthermore, we observed that annotated judgments are hardly ever made publicly available, and that when specified evaluation frameworks are not standardized. As a result, our first recommendation is simply to include all these details. We further discuss recommendations next. So releasing annotations, making human annotated judgments available would enable the development of better annotation metric, automatic metrics. If all annotations had been released with the paper reviewed, we estimate that more than 10,000 human judgments per evaluation aspect would be available. This would be suffice to train and evaluate dedicated evaluation models. In addition, raw annotations can shed light on the difficulty of the tasks and nature of the data. They can be aggregated in multiple ways or used to account for annotator bias. Finally, releasing the annotated judgments makes it possible to replicate and further analyze the evaluation outcomes. Standardizing evaluation protocols. Standardizing evaluation protocols is the key to establishing fair comparison across systems and to improve evaluation frequency and improve evaluation itself. Our survey sheds light on the most frequently used style transfer framework in prior work, yet more research is used to clarify how to evaluate, compare, and replicate the protocols. For instance, Mir et al. Point to evidence that relative judgments can be more reliable than absolute human judgments as part of the work on designing automatic metrics for style transfer evaluation. However, research on human evaluation of machine translation shows that this can change depending on the specifics of the annotation task. Relative judgments were replaced by direct assessment when Graham et al. Showed that both intra and inter-annotated agreement could be improved by using a continuous rating scale instead of a previously common 5 or 7 point interval scale. For ST, the lack of detail and clarity is describing evaluation protocol makes it clear to improve them, as has been pointed out for other NLG tasks who propose evaluation data sheets for clear documentation of human evaluation. Lee 2020 and Vanderlee et al. 2020, who propose best practice guidelines, and Bells et al. 2020-21, who raise concerns regarding reproducibility. The issue is particularly salient for ST tasks where stylistic changes are defined implicitly by data and where the instruction given by human judges for style transfer might be only explicit characterization of the style dimension targeted. Furthermore, since style transfer includes rewriting text across to pragmatic aspects of language use, who the human judgments are matters, since in communication norms and expectations might result in different judgments for the same text. So I think I missed a line. Furthermore, since ST includes rewriting text according to pragmatic aspects of language use, who the human judgments are matters, since differences in communication norm and expectation might result in different judgments for the same text. Right, so different people have different ways of evaluating stuff. Standardizing and describing protocols is also key to assessing the alignment of the evaluation models and to understand potential biases and ethical issues that might arise, so like compensation mechanisms. So I think overall this paper really pinpointed out on some of the major problems which style transfer papers have and how to fix them. So it would be really great if papers in the future fix this stuff. And as always, it was a fun ride to read it, especially a not so mathematically heavy paper. In fact, a not at all mathematically heavy paper after a bunch of papers who throw jargon of probability at you. So I'd love to read more such papers as well. So if you have any suggestions, do comment them down below. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope to see you the next time.